Good morning, children. We're so glad you could join us for today's online Sunday school service. Today's lesson title is God Has Good Plans for His Children. The program is as follows. We'll start with a praise song, then we'll have a COVID sensitization, followed by a Bible quiz and today's memory verse with Auntie Tama. Then we'll have a worship session, followed by a lesson with Teacher Jessica. Stay blessed.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, declares the Lord. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, declares the Lord.
Hannah has been a little scared about COVID-19. So Hannah's friend told her about 5 things her parents said can help them stay safe and strong. We can follow these things as well. Here are 5 safety rules. Number 1. Stay home. Avoid crowded places. But if you do go out, remember to always wear a mask. Number 2. Always social distance. Keep 1 meter apart between you and the next person. All right, I hope you got that. The third thing you can do is wash your hands with soap and water. Make sure to wash for a nice long time. The fourth thing is to make sure that you eat healthy food. This is so you can keep your body strong every day. And the last and most important thing is to remember that God is in control. So Hannah remembered that as a child of God, she must believe that one day God will take this coronavirus away. Here is what the Bible says. Now, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loves us. Romans 8, verse 37. God is with us and way bigger than COVID-19. Do not be afraid. Stay safe, keep clean, and stay healthy. See you next time.
Why, hello, kids, and welcome to today's quiz time. Today we have a game of stand or sit, a Bible game. All right, your instructions are very simple. Answer the following questions by sitting or standing. Did you get that? All right, question one. How many disciples did Jesus have? Stand for 12 disciples or sit for 15 disciples? You have 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. Time's up. What was your answer? That's right. Jesus had 12 disciples. I hope you stood up. All right, question two. Which disciple was a tax collector? Stand for Simon Peter or sit for Matthew? You have 10 seconds. Alright, time's up. So, which disciple was a tax collector? The answer is Matthew. Alright, good job. Question 3. Who in the Bible was sold because his brothers were jealous of him? Stand for Joseph and sit for Jesus. You have 10 seconds. All right, time's up. The answer is Joseph. That's right. Joseph was sold by his brothers because they were jealous of him. All right, question 4. What was the name of Abraham's wife? Stand for Sarah or sit for Mary? You have 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. The answer is Sarah. That's right. I hope you stood up. The name of Abraham's wife was Sarah. All right. Question 5. How many books does the Bible have? Stand for 100 books or sit for 66 books? You have 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. I hope you guessed right. How many books does the Bible have? 66! That's right. Alright, you did a great job. See you next time.
Today's memory verse is from the book of Jeremiah 29 and verse 11. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Today's memory verse is from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29 and verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future.
Your light will shine when all else fades, never ending. Your glory goes beyond all fame.
Dear Lord, thank you for forgiving us our sins. Help us to be kind and forgiving to others as well. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning, boys and girls, and a warm welcome to our Sunday school class. I'm your teacher for the day, and I'm Auntie Jessica. It's so nice to see all of you. I'm excited and looking forward to being with you today. So, we're going to start with stories. How many of you love stories? I also love stories. So today I'm going to tell you a story about a young couple that visited a boarding home care institution, or a place where they kept children that needed to be adopted. So the caretaker brought all these children together, lined them up, they were clean, they just bathed, they had good manners, and they were looking very friendly. So this couple then decided to inspect these children. They asked them questions, they'd speak to one child and speak to another child, and they kept finding all these children, but they couldn't find the perfect one. So after some time, they asked the caretaker and said, "Do you have any more children?" The caretaker replied and said, "Yes, but there are these two children who just arrived, not very clean, they're not dressed, and they're not ready." The couple said, "Can we see them? Can we have just a few words with them?" After a few minutes, these two children came in, very dirty, a boy and a girl, dirty, faces unwashed, hair uncombed, the clothes were torn, and they didn't even have any shoes, and their heads were hanging down in shame. So after a few minutes, the couple then talked and they began to cry, and wiping the tears from their eyes, they said to the caretaker, "We want these two children. We want to adopt them. We want them to be our children." The man replied and said, "But they're not as nice as the other children. They have no manners, and not even their own parents want them." And then he continued to say, "And they're very ill-mannered, and they cannot behave themselves. They're very rude. So why do you want them?" Then the couple replied and said, "We see in them the blessings of God for our home and a better home in life for them." With shame, the man asked, "Do you want me to clean them up?" And the couple said, "No, we want these children just the way they are." And so this couple took their children and they raised them up in the fear and knowledge of God. And they grew up to be a good young woman and a good young man. And many years later, the parents died. And guess what, boys and girls? These adopted children were given everything that the parents had. The land, the houses, the cars became theirs. And so from our story today, these children who were dirty and loved and cared for are just like us. Before we gave our lives to God, we were filled with sin. And when Jesus came into our lives, He forgave us of our sins, He cleaned us up, and He made us whole again. So when we look at our story, we look at the boy and the girl who then took what was given to them by their parents. We call them heirs. And if you look at these parents and what they did, it represents the love that God has for us. So you've just heard a new word, isn't it? Heir. It's spelled H-E-I-R. So who's an heir? Not hair, not air, it's hair. So an heir is a person, it can be a boy or a girl, a man or a woman, that receives an inheritance, that receives something that is given to them when a parent or a guardian dies. So he or she receives a share, it can be a possession, it can be money, it can be a house, it can be anything, but it's given to them as a right because they are a son or a daughter of this mother, father, or guardian. So boys and girls, in the same way, the children in the story were adopted, we've also been adopted as children of God. In John 1 and verse 12, I would want you to open to John 1. In verse 12, I hope you have your Bibles ready with you. the Bible says, those who received him, he gave them the right to become the children of God. That's right. He gave them the right to be called the children of God. And this means as children of God, you and I have full rights to receive an inheritance. So, we've talked about being an heir of God. Now I want you to focus on three things that we're going to look at that I want you to remember throughout the week, throughout the year, and the rest of your life. So as an heir of God, there are three things that you should remember. Number one, always remember that you are a child of God. When you accept Jesus as your Lord and your personal Savior and He comes into your heart, you become a child of God. Galatians 4 verse 7 tells us that you're no longer a slave, but God's child. And since you're a child, God has made you also an heir. So meaning everything that God owns belongs to us as well, because we belong to God. So you remember in the Garden of Eden, when God created everything, He gave it to man, isn't it? So everything that we have that belongs to God is ours. So sometimes you may think that because something bad or something sad happens to you, then you're no longer a child of God. So imagine, as a child, sometimes you make a mistake, you do what is not right, you fight, maybe you steal, you take something that is not yours. Does your mother come and say, "That's it, you're no longer a child, get out of my house"? That never happens, because your parents love you. They always embrace you. When you ask for their forgiveness, they take you into their loving arms because you are their child. So boys and girls, in this world, there's a lot of suffering. There's a lot of pain. There are a lot of troubles, a lot of difficulties. But just because there are difficulties, or just because you fall sick or you're struggling in school, doesn't mean that you are not God's child. You are a child of God. God is with you always. I want you to remember this, boys and girls. You're a son. You are a daughter of God. And this cannot change. It will never change. Number two, God has an assignment for you. God has an assignment for you. And as long as you have not fulfilled your assignment, you're not going anywhere. God will not take you away. So don't be afraid of anything. I know a lot of us now are more scared about COVID-19. Everyone is talking about the second wave. And now they are saying that even children are having COVID. A number of schools are closing because children are testing positive to the COVID-19. And obviously, you're now scared. But always remember to follow the guidelines. You mask up, you sanitize, you wash your hands. Keep doing that. But even if there is COVID, do not fear, because God is with you. In Isaiah 46 and verse 10, the Bible says, "I make known the end from the beginning, from ancient times, what is still to come. I say my purpose will stand, and I will do all that I please." God knows your end from your beginning. So He knows your future. He knows what is to come. I want you to remember that you will not leave this world, you will not leave this earth until you finish the work that God has given you. God has an assignment for you. God has an assignment for me, for your mom, for your dad. God has an assignment for all of us. I want us to just break for a moment and just watch this short video on Jeremiah 29 and verse 11.
"The Plans I Have for You," written by Amy Parker, illustrated by Vanessa Brantley Newton. Hey you, I've got big plans for you. Yes, you, and you, and you over there too. You are my hands and my feet there on earth. I've given you a purpose. It's been there since birth. Oh, it's no little purpose. I don't do things small. Yours is the most humongous purpose of all. So open your heart and listen real close. You'll find that one thing that you love the most. The whole world will be better, thanks to little old you. All because you did what I created you to do. The plans I have for you. Available wherever books are sold.
All right, so did you hear that? Jeremiah 29 and verse 11 says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." That's one of my favorite scriptures, and I'd want you to memorize it as well. So you may have your own dreams, your own plans, but God has something better. God has something bigger for you. God has got a greater purpose. So you might say, "No, I'm just a little boy. I'm just a little girl." God has a great plan for you. His hand is over your life. And according to His will, you will become the doctor, teacher, businessman, lawyer, scientist, farmer, mechanic, banker, pilot, maybe even the president. Maybe you might even find the real vaccine of COVID-19. God has a purpose for you. Always remember that you're not alone. God is with you. Seek God with your heart, and He will show you your assignment. So there are a lot of us who say, "No, but I'm not so sure." Keep asking God, and God will lead you. God will guide you towards the purpose that He has for you. So always remember Jeremiah 20:19. When you feel sad, when you feel low, and you heard from our song earlier on, I hope you're going to be singing that song for the whole week. Always remember that God has got a plan for you. Number three, with everything that we've been talking about, as believers and as Christians, God says that He will protect us and He will take care of us. Even the Bible says 1,000 may fall by your side, 10,000 may fall on your right hand, but no harm will come near you. Boys and girls, are you scared? Are you scared about your safety during COVID-19? Are you scared for mommy and daddy when they go to work? Are you scared for your sister and your brother? Don't worry. You will live. You will not die. You will live, and you will live to declare the works of the Lord. Boys and girls, everything will be fine. I came to encourage you today to say you will survive. Remember Noah and his family in the ark? What happened? It began to rain, but they were covered and they were protected by God. So in the same way, God will cover and protect you from sickness and disease. Our memory verse for today is coming from Jeremiah 29 and verse 11. And it says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." And that future in Christ is a good future. All right, boys and girls, there's some of you that are listening to us maybe for the first time, or you've been watching our services for a while now, and you keep telling yourself, "But Auntie Jess, I want to be a child of God, but I don't know how to be a child of God." I want to remind you of John 3:16, where the Bible says, "For God so loved the world that He sent His only begotten Son, so that he who believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." And don't beat yourself up, because all of us have sinned. Everyone sins. As long as you are a human being, you will sin. All of us have fallen short of the glory of God. But when you call upon the name of the Lord, you will be saved. So I want you to repeat this prayer after me. I want you to mean it with all your heart. Close your eyes. Bow down in reverence to God, in respect to God, and repeat after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe that you died for my sins and rose from the dead. I turn from my sins and I invite you to come into my heart, into my life, to be my Lord and personal Savior. In Jesus' name, I pray with thanksgiving in my heart. Amen. Amen and amen. Guess what? You're now a child of God. And everything that I talked about earlier, those three things apply to you. So I want you to run and go and tell your mommy, your daddy, your auntie, your uncle, anyone older. Tell them the decision that you have made and they'll be able to guide you in the steps that you should take. And they can also write to us or they can email us or follow us here at Northmead Assembly of God to get more details. Now, children, I would want us to also pray concerning the topic that we had today and the lesson that we had. So I want us to pray even concerning what is happening so that God will give us courage and strength as we move on in our lives. So let us pray. Our Lord and our God, we thank you for giving us life and for keeping us. Lord, we believe that you're the God that keeps us in hard times, in difficult times, and even in these times of COVID-19. Lord, we pray for your protection over our families, over our mothers, fathers, brothers, sisters, and friends, and over the people of Zambia. Lord, we thank you for the great plans that you have for us, plans to prosper us and not to harm us. We thank you, Lord, for loving us, and we know that we are your children. In Jesus' name, we pray with thanksgiving in our hearts. Amen and amen. So we've come to the end of our class, boys and girls. This has been Auntie Jessica. We'll see you next time. Bye.